Hi guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Now, I hope that you all are doing very well in managing your studies. And in order to add something to your knowledge, I have brought the current affairs for October 20, 2020. So in this video, I will be discussing 10 very important news from the day. And these news items are going to be very relevant for your examination for banks like RBI, SEBI, NABARD or any kind of bank at the PO level. So let's start this video, but before that I would like you guys to subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification to get the instant notification. Then also join this Telegram group, the link is in the description box below. So here we have the table of contents and I know that it's a quite lengthy list. So don't get worried, don't be worried, because we will be discussing all the news items in a very crisp manner so that you don't have to wait for a long period of time and you can retain things better. So in the first news, we will be discussing about the panel of secretaries that has been formed by central government for spectrum allocation process. Then INS Sindhuveer. Then we have Supreme Court's one-man committee to curb stubble burning, crop stubble burning. Then the Lancet's report on India's life expectancy. Then we have Sujal drink from tap mission, which is a state mission. So we will be discussing that in the fifth news. Then we have Committee on Professional Engineers Bill, quite an important news. Then we have a military exercise, which is named as Suraksha Kavach, world's biggest zinc smelter project. Now this is the world's biggest zinc smelter project. That is why this is very important for us to know. Now guys, this is going to be in India. So quite a cherishing moment that the world's biggest plant is going to be in India. So what are the details? We will be discussing that in eighth news. Then we have Evolve, which is India's first online platform for non-ferrous metals. Then India's MOU for surface and groundwater. So these are the things that we are going to discuss in today's video. So watch this video till the end, listen to me carefully, and in between, if you find any kind of trouble in understanding anything, do feel free to mention it in the comment section. So here comes our first question. Who heads the panel of secretaries formed by central government for streamlining the telecom spectrum allocation process? Now, what is this telecom spectrum? Spectrum is the internet waves, and India usually conducts auction to allocate the spectrum. Spectrum is 5G, 4G, 2G, and right now we are in the midst of allocating 5G network. So that is why this panel has been formed in order to streamline the entire process. Now, who is the chief? It is option C, Rajiv Gupta. Now he is also the cabinet secretary. So this is the most important point here, that he is also the cabinet secretary and he is the head of this panel of secretaries for telecom spectrum allocation process. So that's all for this question. I hope that it is clear to you, and you will be telling me in the comment section that who heads the union cabinet. So it's a very obvious question. I think that all of my students would know the answers. So do mention your answers in the comment section below. So this is our next question, which is, to which country has India announced to deliver a kilo class submarine named as INS Sindhuveer? Now do remember the name as well. It is very important from the exam point of view. So recently India has announced to deliver this INS Sindhuveer to which country? It is Myanmar. Now, an interesting point here is that Myanmar does not have any submarine till now, and INS Sindhuveer will be the first submarine that Myanmar is going to have. Quite interesting, right? Now, from the exam point of view, what are the points that you need to remember? First is this point itself. Second is the capital, currency, and the president of Myanmar. So these are the static things that you need to remember about Myanmar from the exam point of view, and you will be telling me the answers of all these three questions in the comment section below. And we have discussed everything about this question, and now it's our third question. So recently, Supreme Court has formed a panel So let's discuss what this panel is and what is the question about. Who has been appointed as the one-man committee by Supreme Court to curb the crop stubble burning in Punjab, Haryana and Western Uttar Pradesh, which chokes Delhi NCR? Quite easy to understand the purpose. And now the main important point that we have to pay our attention to is that it is a one-man committee. And who is the head of this committee? So it is C. Justice Madan B. Lockwood. So he is the head of this one-man committee. Now this reminds me that Delhi CM Arvind Kejriwal has also launched recent initiatives to curb pollution in Delhi. So what are those initiatives? First is the Youth Pradushan ke Virudh. So it is Youth's Fight. Pradushan is pollution. Now guys, I am translating it for those who don't know Hindi. So those who don't who know Hindi, keep patience here. In English, it will be translated as fight against pollution. So this is the initiative that Delhi CM Arvind Kejriwal has launched. And under this initiative, there will be 7 steps that the Delhi government is going to take. So what are those steps? Those steps are mentioned here. So first step will be combating dust. Then the next step will be hotspot management. Then setting up of a green app, war room setup. New transplantation policy. Now guys, this transplantation policy has been discussed in PIB 247 session. So I hope that you all have seen those sessions. And if you have not, then do watch that PIB 247 session in which this new tree transplantation policy has been discussed at length. Now we have action against stubble burning and encouraging electric vehicles. So you can see that all these 7 steps mentioned in the picture here are very obvious and are very general points. Therefore, you don't need to pay any kind of extra effort in order to memorize these steps. And secondly, these are not very important from the examination point of view. I mentioned this picture as well as the initiative in order to help you understand the larger picture and the initiatives of government towards the stubble burning. Now this is first initiative, and what is the second initiative? The second initiative is red light on the day off. So this initiative is to promote save fuel. So it is to promote awareness among the vehicle owners and drivers to switch off their vehicles when they are on the red line. So this is the basic purpose of this initiative. So these two are the initiatives that you should keep in mind in order to understand the larger picture, that what are the steps that state government and the central government are taking in order to curb the pollution in Delhi NCR. Now let's come to our next question, which is, which state has the lowest life expectancy rate in 2019? Quite important question it is. Do listen to me very carefully. As per the Lancet's report. Now guys, you need to understand this thing, that the Lancet is a journal, and in this journal a report has been published, and this report is not named. So there is no name of this report. So that is why it is the Lancet's report. It is known as the Lancet's report. Now, as per this report, the life expectancy rate in India has been increased from 1999 to 2019. So what is that increased amount? What is that increased number that we will be discussing later on? But first, let's discuss the answer of this question. So which state has the lowest life expectancy? Guess. Can you make a guess here? It is Uttar Pradesh. It has the lowest expectancy rate, life expectancy rate. So what is the rate? It is 66.9 years. Now if we are talking about lowest, then we should also know about the highest. So which state has the highest life expectancy rate? It is Kerala.
at 77.3 years.
So these are the two facts that you should keep in mind from this report. Now apart from this, as I mentioned that there are other facts, that there is the fact that India's life expectancy rate has increased in 2019. So what is that rate? Let's discover that in the next slide. So in this slide, as you can see that I have mentioned pointers here, so you can remember the news better. So first point is, India's life expectancy rate has increased to 70.8 years from 59.6 years in 1990. So this is the latest life expectancy rate. You should remember this rate. This is very important from the exam point of view. What is the next point? The next point is that the study has covered 200 countries. So what does that indicate? This indicates that this study is not specifically for India. It has covered 200 countries, and out of the main facts, I have chosen the facts that are relevant from the exam point of view and that are related to India. So that is why these points are important and they are related to India only. Now we have the third point, which is 58% of the total disease burden in India is now due to non-communicable diseases. This is quite a shocking fact that 58% of the disease burden is due to the non-communicable diseases, which are relatively chronic. So that is why this is horrifying and it is terrible. Now what is the second point here? That premature deaths due to non-communicable diseases have more than doubled to 50%. That is why I said that it is a horrifying fact, it is the horrifying reality that non-communicable diseases have increased in India. Now we have the last fact, which is child and maternal malnutrition is still the number one risk factor for illness and death in India, followed by air pollution. Now guys, you would know the reason that why I had mentioned the Delhi government's initiatives to curb air pollution, because of this reason that air pollution is also one of the largest causes of deaths and illness in India. That is why it is very important for us to keep a track of things that government is doing to curb this air pollution. Apart from this, this child and maternal malnutrition reminds me of a very key report. So what is that report? This report is related to stillbirth. Now this stillbirth report has been released by United Nations very recently, and Manish Sir in his PIB247 has covered this report at length. So I hope that you will see that session and understand what the major important points were there in this report. So one main important point is that India has the largest stillbirths in the world. And why is that? Because of this child and maternal malnutrition. So here these things are interconnected, and that is why you should keep a track of things which are interlinked in order to understand what the bigger picture is. And so here that question ends, and we will be discussing our next question. So this next question is about the state scheme. So which state has launched the Sujal Drink from Tap mission? Now Sujal is, Su means good, and Jal is water. So what is the purpose? Provide quality drinking water from taps to urban household. So first of all, this mission is in line with the Jal Jeevan mission of central government. So the Jal Jeevan mission aims to provide household tap connections by 2024 to rural households, and this mission is for urban households. So this is the basic demarcation that you need to remember about this scheme. Now which state has launched it? It is Odisha. That's all. This is the news only. So you have to remember this one line fact. It is a very factual and interesting news as well. So here this news ends and you have to tell me the CM of Odisha. Now the next question is, which committee is preparing the professional engineers bill? Do remember this thing, that this bill has not been prepared yet. It is still in the stage of being drafted. Now which committee is doing that? It is MS Anand committee. Now recently Minister of Education, Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank, has announced that AICTE is All India Council of Technical Education, has appointed this committee to draft the professional engineers bill. Now what is the purpose of this bill? Since this bill is in the stage of being drafted, therefore there are no provisions of this bill that are in the public. So what is the basic idea of this bill? You have to keep in mind that only for the time being. So the basic idea is to create a national body like we have for law, medicine and for other professions like CA. So the body that is going to be established by this bill will register engineers in India. So basically, to register engineers who are practicing in India, a council will be established by this bill. So that is the main purpose of this bill for the time being, because the provisions are not out yet. I hope that you will remember the facts that I have mentioned here, and in case if you have any kind of query, do feel free to ask me in the comment section. So let's move on to our next question, which is, exercise Suraksha Kavach, a joint anti-terrorist exercise was conducted between whom? Now this is a very unique exercise. Why? The reason is that it has been conducted between Indian Army and Indian Police. So quite a unique exercise it is, because we have not seen any exercise being conducted between Army and Police so far. Now this exercise is conducted between the Maharashtra Police and Indian Army. Now where is it conducted? It is conducted in Lula Nagar, Pune. These are some of the facts that you should remember from the exam point of view. And what is the purpose of this exercise? It is an anti-terrorist exercise. So quite easy to understand the purpose, and these are the facts that you have to remember from the exam point of view. Name of the exercise, the organizations, that is Police and Army, the branch Maharashtra Police, the place Lula Nagar, Pune. So these are the facts you should remember. Now comes our next question, which is, which state has signed an MOU with Hindustan Zinc Limited for setting up the world's biggest zinc smelter project? Now first of all, what is the meaning of smelter? Do you guys know it? So if you know it, then do mention it in the comment section below. I would also like to hear it from you. So this world's biggest zinc smelter project is going to be developed in India, and a state has signed an MOU with Hindustan Zinc Limited. So which state is it? It is Gujarat. So Gujarat has signed this MOU with Hindustan Zinc Limited. Now guys, if you are saying that it is going to be world's biggest zinc smelting project, then we should also know the capacity of this project, don't you think so? So what is the project, what is the capacity of this project? It is 300 kilotons per annum. It is a very basic fact but important as well. Then what is the investment? It is ₹10,000 crores. Again, these two facts are very basic but can be asked in the examination, therefore no chance of leaving them behind. You have to remember them as well. It is in spite of this fact that Gujarat and Hindustan Zinc Limited have partnered for this project. Now my question for you is that you have to tell me who is the head of Hindustan Zinc Limited, who is the chairman of this organization. That is your homework for the day. And now let's move on to the next question. So the next question is, which company has launched Evolve?
Evolve is India's first online buying platform for non-ferrous metals.
Non-ferrous metals are those metals which are not made from iron, which are not non-iron metals. So which company has done so? So it is the same company which has signed MOU with Gujarat for the world's largest zinc smelter project. So the answer is Hindustan Zinc Limited. And do not forget that you are mentioning your answers about the question that who is the head of this company. Do mention it in the comment section. Now guys, I hope that there is nothing to discuss here. It's very easy from the title that it is India's first online buying platform. So what would be the function of this platform? To facilitate trade of non-ferrous metals. Quite easy. Now we have come to the last question of the day. So the last question is, with which country has India signed an MOU for cooperation in surface and groundwater usage? The MOU was between Central Groundwater Board and Marvi Partners. So which country is it?
It is Australia.
With Australian agency Marvi Partners, India's Central Groundwater Board has signed this MOU to provide training and awareness, to create awareness about the usage of ground water as well as surface water. Now it is very important for us, and I don't think that I need to explain what is the importance of conserving water. You are understanding enough that you can understand the purpose and the importance of ground water. And now my question for you is that you have to tell me who is the PM of Australia. This is also very important, and I hope that you will mention all your answers in the comment section below. And here our session ends for today. I hope that you have liked it, and if you have any kind of query, you can mention it in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching the video.